incubator of hate.
Yes, but the English government has never done that.
No.
This is very strange because this is the result of 10 years of policy of Blair and of the Labour government. The Labour government always pandered to the Islamists. And London had become for years the center of Islamists.
Yes.
And why they did that? Were they afraid? Did England bought its security, relative security, by allowing Islamists to, by giving asylum to Islamists? And because terrorism is everywhere in Europe, and you know, you buy your security since 1973, since Europe has made this deal with terrorists, with the Palestinian terrorism, to recognize them, to receive them, so to honor them. So this, Europe has lost the control of its own security. It relies for its security on the honor it it gives to the terrorists.
Yeah.
And to ransom money. We are paying billions to Palestinians without even knowing what they are doing with this money.
Well, but we know they're buying weaponry, we know that they're arming.
So the taxpayer is in fact paying to terrorist gang for its security. This is what we are doing in Europe.
It's like the DiMi,
we are paying for our security. We live under the regime of dimitude without European knowing it. Because the whole of the West is doing that. The whole of the West is paying security money. We haven't fought this war.
No.
The war against terrorism, we haven't fought.
Okay. I want to talk to you about George
Bush. We thought we get rid of Israel, it is only Israel, and that's finished. We saw it under a small angle. We didn't saw the enormous implication in morality, in also in political, strategic angles, but also culturally, because our universities are are submitted to a cultural jihad. And this is the reason why
our universities have submitted to a cultural jihad. Go ahead.
Yes, because we adopt the Islamist view of history, which deny the history of dimitude, the history of the dimis, deny. This is why we don't know it in the West. Before that, before this change in the policy in 1973, this history of Islamic expansion and Islamic treatment of the countries it has conquered and the population it has conquered and submitted were very well known. It was taught in universities.
It was taught in universities.
Yes, this is 40 years ago, 50 years ago. This was absolutely because there were texts on that. There were books, Muslim books.
This is what Ephraim Karsh is always so upset about, because the books now are historically inaccurate.
Yes, everything is inaccurate because of the Islamization and Palestinization of the universities, because it is in the universities that the Palestinian cult against Israel, against the West, against America developed. It is in fact the Palestinization of universities that have totally obfuscated this reality, the history. And us in the West, we are the heir of rationalism, of the Greek and Roman civilization. We have to have our studies are based on fact on rationalism, and they should be separate from policies. They should not be submitted to policies. Now we are submitted to policy.
I got it. Now I want to ask you something else. I want to ask you about George Bush. George Bush after 9/11 was right there. You know, the Bush Doctrine I thought was gorgeous. I thought it was a gorgeous doctrine. Any terrorist, any state sponsor of terror. But there's been a change. There's been a change in his policy. This meeting with the Muslim Brotherhood we'd like to have. I mean, Condi is reaching out. This latest visit to the Saudi-funded Islamic Center, where he appointed a special envoy to the OIC. What do you think happened to George Bush?
Well, George Bush has been weakened internally.
He's been weakened internally
by
the left.
Yes, by the left.
Yes.
He cannot, and also by the evolution of the war in Iraq and by the situation in general in the world and the nuclearization of Iran, which was not in the cards.